permissions. This is what a directory and a file would look like in a directory listing. We're going to talk about the section over here. There are 9 characters that can go at the end here, and those determine the permissions. There's 1 character in the beginning. This character can be a dash, a D, or an L. If it's a D, it means it's a directory. If it's a dash, it means it's a file. If it's an L, it means it's a symlink. Okay, now I'm going to describe these 9 characters. They're divided into groups of 3. The first 3 correspond to the owner of the file or directory. The second 3 correlate to the group which is associated or owns the directory or file. The last 1 is for everyone else. That's commonly referred to as other. Okay, R stands for read. And if what this correlates to is a file, then it means the reading can be done to the file. So you could read the file. If it's a directory, then you can list the directory and see what's in it. The second is write. When that relates to a file, it means you can write to the file, modify the file, or delete the file. If the W is associated with a directory, then it means that you can add content to this directory or delete the directory. The last one is the X. X stands for execute. If the X is associated with a file, it means that you can run the file as a program or a script. If the X is associated with a directory, it means that you can enter the directory using the CD command, or you could search the directory using the find command. Okay, now as I said, there are 3 different sets of 3 characters. 3 times 3 is 9. The first set of 3, the owner, the second set is associated with the group, and the third is associated with everyone else. So now you understand what this 9 character string means in a listing. Remember, it's 9 plus 1 more, so there's 10.